A C-19 vaccine trial that was supposed to start this week has been delayed, but scientists are still hopeful that vaccinations could be ready by early next year. Our investigative reporter Brendan Kirby spoke with an Alabama researcher who's helping to test these vaccines. And Brendan, how much longer are we going to have to wait?
Well, Byron, January is a plausible target, but the Moderna delay is an indication of how many things can slow progress. Dr. Paul Gepfert, director of the Alabama Vaccine Research Clinic at the University of Alabama at Birmingham, isn't part of the Moderna research. He's working with drug company Pfizer on a study this month to test the immune responses to a potential vaccine. Next month, he'll work with AstraZeneca on a clinical trial to determine if another vaccine is effective. The site in Birmingham, one of 150 across the country, will be recruiting volunteers. Researchers in government and the private sector are confident that an effective vaccine is on the way, but Gepfert says that the testing and evaluation are crucial prerequisites.
We have vaccines now. You could start vaccinating people, but you don't know if they work. More importantly, you don't know if they make the disease worse. And there are situations where vaccines during development, we found out that, you know, oh no, it's actually making you more susceptible to infection, or it's making the disease worse if you get infected.
But Gepfert says the process is moving at a much faster pace than typically would be the case for vaccine development. He's working with the private drug companies as part of a government program called Operation Warp Speed, which aims to deliver vaccines as fast as possible. As part of that program, the federal government has put up massive amounts of money for drug companies to begin production even before the vaccines have passed the preliminary hurdles. Ordinarily, it can take another whole year to actually manufacture vaccines that have been proven safe and effective.
That's sort of the whole premise of Operation Warp Speed, because that kind of stuff doesn't impact the safety of a vaccine. So you can still test the safety to make sure it's safe and speed things along without impacting the safety analysis, which obviously is extremely important.
When a vaccine is ready to launch, Gepfert says it probably will be distributed in stages, starting first with the people at the highest risk. Reporting live for Fox 10 News, this is Brendan Kirby.